Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Dark Souls, and to SideQuest, and to the other side of the Belfry Tower thing here, whatever we just went through with the gargoyles and such. Time to see what's down this ladder. Other than many dogs. So many dogs. Wow. Okay, how best to deal with too many dogs. This could get messy. But I want the stuff, so here we go. So many dogs! So many dogs. Got one of them. Yeah, and I'm being invaded? This seems like a bit much. Let's climb. Hey, Dark Spirit. I missed your name. All the dogs you see. Come on up. Come on up and we'll have words. Large, swordy words. You coming up? You really should come up here. Are you not coming up? Are you really being that jerk? Won't even climb a ladder? You're an interesting looking sort. Yeesh. Alright, so there's just dogs everywhere. Lousy with dogs, this place. Alright, well. Yeah, get me out. Leave. Let's run up here. Let's use Capra Demon tactics. Get out of here. Get out of here. That didn't do much that I'd hoped. Let's get out of here. Okay. Take care of dogs. Vorgul the Sinner. Cool. Great. Love it. Super duper cool. Leave me alone. Yeah. Get out of here. Get out of here. Okay. 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 Cool. Got some dogs. Got the other dog. That might be all the dogs. Ah. Not good at aiming this. This will take some practice. Yeesh. Okay. Use caution. More caution. More caution than that. Alright, drink break. Fair enough. Okay. Kind of want to jumping attack this guy. Oh, that's not what I meant to do. That was awesome, though. As was that. This is fun. You die now! Ha ha! Oh boy. That was an intimidating scenario. Quite something, you say. I will be the judge of that. Enchanted Falchion? 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 I have no idea how to pronounce that. I should learn. Any hidden walls? No? Okay. Here's another item. Dragon Tooth Petrified Something Bright Bug. My, my. So the petrified something I can take to the crows. Bright bug I don't completely know what is. Is that the thing that allows... It's not the same as the firefly bug things with the torches, is it? Maybe it is. And the dragon's tooth. That's an old Havel weapon. Or it was Havel's in Dark Souls 1 anyway. Chest, huh? Uh-huh. Nothing. Well, anyway, I got some items. And I beat a dark spirit, so I call that a win. Gorgeous view ahead. It's true. I agree. It's rather lovely. This has been a big zone. But I think we might be pretty much at the end of it now. I'm sure there are bits and pieces I've missed, but think we're about done here. I think it's time to head back to Huntsman's Copse. Which is closer? Probably this. I want to get my way back up to the fog door with the red spirit. Or the dark spirit, rather. I guess that's the proper term. Okay. Back here again. With a large sword. Yeah. Sword works. And if I keep cranking up my strength, eventually, I'll be able to one-hand this thing. That'll be fun. I'm enjoying this. The mace is great, but crushing enemies with this thing is pretty fun too. Ah, forgot about you. Hello. Swat. Ah, thought that would kill you. Didn't quite. This will though. Yep, I am enjoying this great sword. This is a good time. This might end up becoming the new main. Although, I do- oh, forgot about the poison. Forgot about the poison! Although, I do intend to, hang on. Butterfly problems. I do intend to try other weapons. If for no other reason than just kind of for fun and to see the breadth of variety available. I think once I get to a point in the game where I can either farm for Titanite infinitely, or can farm for souls and can purchase Titanite infinitely. Because I don't think there's anyone that I can do that from currently. I think they all have limited stock. Once I hit that point, I will probably do a lot of farming off camera. Or maybe not even farming. I may just, like, do a bunch of multiplayer off camera. Just helping other people out against bosses and in different areas. Gather a whole bunch of souls, buy a whole bunch of Titanite, level a whole bunch of weapons to a point where they are usable and of comparable strength to the ones that I'm using as my mains. And then we can try a whole bunch of them out during this playthrough. Kind of like what I did toward the end of Dark Souls 1, where I leveled up a bunch of weapons to plus 10 just so we could sample a bunch and I could settle on a favorite. Which I eventually did, and that favorite was the Great Scythe. Big fan. So now... ah! Dog, forgot about you. Been a while since I was here. I don't remember you at all. Get out of here. So, I believe I'm headed back... did I get turned around? I don't think that- oh, this isn't the right way. Yep, I got turned around. The bridge I wanted to take is, I think, that one down there. Yeah. Sorry about that. I'm sure there's so much else down here I've not yet investigated. Like, there's that bonfire that's in that- ugh, watch it. There's that bonfire that's in that hut over there. Lock on. I gotta remember, I need to lock on with this weapon, or I'm going to miss. Oh yeah, there's that bonfire and that little hutch up there that I couldn't figure out how to get to. And there's this item in here and that guy with the sun shield. Don't really know how to get into these places. Probably through the same route that would get me out through here, but I will find that later with some more exploration. Watch it. Alright. Kaboom. Yee, watch it. I do like this sword's 1-2 combo, but it does wear through the stamina pretty quickly. Which means that if I'm gonna use this as my main, But I need to invest a lot more points in... It's endurance, right? Yeah, it's endurance. All right, here we go. And a one, and a two. Huh, just needed the one. Then we head back around this way, and there's lots of those guys up on their little pedestals. And we just walk in far enough to aggro one at a time. Try jumping attack. Well, no, wait. Missed my opportunity. He's a little close now. Eh, watch it. Watch it. Alright, we'll try jumping attack on the next one. Let's figure out what the actual moveset with this thing is. Probably should have done that earlier. Okay, so there's that. There's the R1. Which I can only get two attacks off before running out of stamina with. There's that one, which is pretty cool. Good for big groups, I assume. Okay, come on up here. And aha! Gotcha. And then... That is annoying. There we go, though. Now, using these big strength weapons is fun. Like, you have to be much more careful choosing the moments you're going to attack, but, if you can land that one attack, it doesn't take many. Ouch. Still gotta be careful, though. And I believe there's one or two more. Yep, there's one. Eh. Yeesh. What's happening with my aim? That is really annoying. I do not know what is causing that. Even while locked on, my R1 aim can go kind of screwy. I feel like there's one more of you. It's gonna drop on me. There you are. Ha! Gotcha first. There we go. Okay, so... Now a moment of truth. Almost. I think there's a couple of other... Hollows who will try to climb up and attack me here. At some point. Can I hit him from here? With this, maybe? Yeah! Got you. And there we are. There we are. Okay. Yeah, don't need anyone sneaking up on me in the middle of a tough fight. In undead purgatory. Okay. Let's get ready to use some caution here. So if memory serves, last time I attacked this guy, I tried to roll out of the way of a jumping attack and really felt like I was out of the way, but then he, like, spun around 180 degrees in mid-air. So clearly I can't just roll around that attack. It's gonna probably connect, no matter what. So I just need to try to manage distance instead. Which I probably should be doing this with the mace, but we'll try it. We'll try it. Let's do this. Yep, that's the one. Yeah. All right. Eh, watch it. Ah. Ha. He's strong though. And this is not a huge fighting environment. I wonder if I can draw him back here. That might be smart. Ah! Okay, careful. Wrong button. That was not the right button at all. Whoo, this is... gotta be careful. Okay. Okay. There is a drop-off back here I need to be aware of. Okay. So long as he doesn't regain health when he goes back, this is fine. This is fine. This is good, in fact. Not R1, R2. R2 and forward is the jumping attack. Take that. And one more. Down you go. Ha ha. With a +3 weapon, no less. I guess I got souls off of him. I expected to see like a dark spirit defeated message or something. Visions of horse. Friend required. Lesser foe ahead in short try guts. Try dashing through and then hurrah for lever. Friend required. Now may be a time to use an effigy. How do you get over there? I could just jump it, I guess. Might be tricky getting an angle here, but let's give it a spin. Ha! Yeah! And a fire seed! Yes! That's good! That's what I need to upgrade pyromancy. I've had a lot of luck with the jumps. I think it's really just down to having a better button for jumping, but pretty pleased with the results. So here's a question. I have a lot of souls. You know what? No need for super caution. Let's just use an effigy, see if there are any friends around who should be summoned for NPC quest reasons. So we're looking for Lucatiel or Benhart. Lucatiel or Benhart. Lucatiel or... Let's head back here, just in case. Lucatiel, Benhart, hello. Hey, there we go. Who do we have? Kaiser. Well, you look cool, but... You are neither Lucatiel nor Benhart. So, we're trying this solo. Because we are reckless. We're not doing this with 3 Estus flasks. And 20,000 souls. If I had full Estus, I would go do it. But... I'm gonna go spend these souls real quick. Actually, I can just drop down. Ooh, I can drop down and get that. In fact. Speaking of recklessness. Okay. Oh, that might kill me though, it's a long fall. Let's swap rings. Okay. I didn't realize I'm heavy. I'm a heavy roll now. Because of this sword. I need to lighten up my gear. I will do that later. Oh wait, I can just drop down here. Okay, that's safer. Should be safer. Unless I make some serious errors. That may be a difficult jump. I think I actually am gonna have to jump to get there. But I'm already out here, so... Oh, there's a place down there I could go. Interesting. All these paths. Okay, can I... I don't know if I can make that jump, but let's try it. Okay, well... Not the jump I meant to make, but... I'm sure you will agree that could have gone worse. So let's just go this way. See what's in here. Other than poison. This is over my initial... This is above, I think, my initial entrance in here? Whatever, let's shoot some butterflies. Down you go. Down you go. Okay. Oh, there's another butterfly. Yikes. Several. They seem to be quite everywhere. Ooh, there's a bottom to this area. With something big down there. Whoa, that is big. I do not intend to fall down there right now. No siree. Nope, nope, nope. Monastery Charm and Soul of a Proud Knight. Glad to have them. I see other items down there. Don't care. Not going down there right now. Nope. Nope, 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 nope. We were in the middle of being cautious. That's why we were headed back this way. And of course we're stranded now. So that sucks. Should I go down there? Is that a completely foolhardy thing to do? Seems like it would be. Get out of here, butterfly. I wonder... That's a huge basilisk! I am not jumping down there. Look at how huge that freaking thing is. Whoa! Yikes. For whatever reason, I mean, it's an enemy I've fought many of in the past, but for whatever reason, make it five times the normal size and it's quite intimidating again. Can I hit this thing from here? Butterfly. Yep. Nope. All right, huge, come on. Trying to get an angle on you here. There is a chest down there. Just when I think I have a plan for where I'm gonna go and what I'm gonna do, I just stumble upon some random side path and get completely distracted. All right, you. Shooting you in the eye. Or the, fake eye. Ha! Come on. Fake eyes! I am not going down there. Not while that thing lives. I enjoy challenges and such, but, everyone has their limit. Butterfly, get out of here. Thank you. I could probably get an angle on him from that mushroom, but then he might be able to hit me with some sort of petrification. Which I am not interested in. Not one bit. See, if this were just a big, scary monstery thing, I would go down and fight it, but when petrification is on the line, that is another matter entirely. Stop hiding from me. Boom 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 shimma baba shimma baba shimma pow boom shimma baba shimma baba shimma pow. And down it goes. Whew, okay. Ah. I feel better with it gone, that's for sure. Now, Let's start heading downward to investigate. I don't think I'll have a chance of getting to that item from there. I think I'd have to go from higher up and drop down to reach that. So instead, let's start dropping down this way. No other basilisks, right? It was just the one? It's super important to me that there was just the one. I feel very, very strongly about it. Old Radiant Life Gem, neat. Hello. Out of my way, please. I have items to gather. Large Titanite Shard, 3 of them. That's great. That may be going right into this here greatsword. Poison Moss. Apologies for the fireworks outside. 4th of July weekend, you understand. And now this chest. Here it goes. What do you got for me? Ricard's rapier, hey! I remember that. Probably still a dex weapon. Or, if not dex, then, I thought you might be. If not dex, then, like, intelligence or magic or something. Still, cool to have it. And hey! Item. Soul item, in fact. And here's a lift. Hey. Don't do anything sneaky, alright? You just sit tight. Where am I? This looks familiar. I think I was up here, Yes. Okay, yes, yeah, we're in this area. Let's start by dealing with you. Hello. It's been so long. And you. Who could forget you? And you also. Boy, I love having longer reach. The mace is great, but, doesn't exactly have range. How do I up? Ah! Didn't see ya. Dark in here. Probably even darker for you folks. Apologies. But trying to cut all of this firework background noise out of the audio is going to be a pain. Ah! Ah! Leave me alone! Hey! Watch it! Watch it! Ha! What do you think of that? I thought it was cool. Get out of here. Where's that bonfire? It's up around here, somewhere. Surprise! Whoops. It always looks like a longer drop than it actually is to me. So, okay, we're back here, and the bonfire is right here. Yes! Good! Huh, summon sign. Who are you? Nefarious. No thank you, but... Here is a bonfire, we're finally back, hooray! What was I doing back here? Oh, that's right, I was going back to Majula, spending some souls, coming back with the actual full Estus flasks for going through the fog door, which I'm going to do before this episode is over. Let's buy some more pieces of that... Is it the Alva set? The one I bought the helm of.
You need armor? Go ahead, see what I'm offering.
I shall. Yeah, it's the Alva set. Okay, I bought the helm earlier. I think I can afford the rest? It's a little late for math over here. So, no, all right, so not quite, but with soul items, I should be able to buy. Oh, no, wait, I can. Boy, I really cannot math tonight. Sorry. Yay, Alvaset.
Thanks for the purchase. Do come again.
You bet, pal. He really is way more confident than he was when we first met. Must be all this money I've given him, or souls I've given him, rather. Let's check out this set here. Armor worn by Alva the Wayfarer. Light, but offers very high defense. Alva crossed many a land in search of a cure for Saint Sarita's sickness, but failed and relinquished his knighthood. Alva was once racked with guilt and remorse, but rediscovered his purpose in life with the aid of the witch who once plotted against him. Well, that's a whole short story happening there. Let's check it out. Well, I must say, this is a rather nice looking set. I like the look. Doesn't quite bring me under 70% equip load, which is a shame. But maybe that almost does it. I was gonna put the Covetous Silver Serpent ring back on, but I probably should use this Ring of Giants if I'm not using a shield. Let's go with that. Oh, wait, I didn't realize that the cat ring was... Ooh, that reduces equip load quite a bit as well. Or maybe it just weighs less. Oh, it weighs less than the Ring of Giants, I see. Okay. Ring of Giants is just a hefty ring. Well, I guess if I lose the shield, that does it. But then, well, I guess all the shield was really giving me was more stamina regain, which I do need. But I can probably get by without it. Hopefully. Because it's not like I can actually use the shield with my current strength and this sword. This'll work. So, okay, here's our current getup. Looking all right. And we got our fast roll, which is good. We're gonna need it. Because we got no shield. But I guess we had no shield before because we're two-handing a weapon that I definitely don't have the strength to wield otherwise. These fireworks are driving me nuts. Are you hearing this? It's not even the fourth yet. Happy Canada Day, I guess. Anyway, I think it's subsided now. So let's go pick a fight to wrap this episode up. Hopefully I'll win. I may not win, but hopefully. If I'm gonna keep using this great sword, which I think I would like to, I am going to need to bump up the vitality and endurance some more. And the strength so that I can one-hand it. That'd be awesome. Who's this? Hello, Sugoi. No, I'm doing this alone. Not what I meant to do. Not what I meant to do either. This I meant to do. And boy, does that feel good when it lands. Ah, hello, hello, hello. Lots of horse talk outside that fog door, which leads me to think there's gonna be some sort of horse-themed boss coming up. I mean, it could be. We shall find out. Ah, I was hoping to stun, but boy, it seems to oh boy, watch it, watch it. Ah! I got distracted thinking, oh no, I'm gonna run off the edge, and then I just actually died. I would end the episode here, but I promised we were going through that fog door, and we are going through that fog door. Ah, that... The aim on this is really finicky. Seriously? Ooh, this is annoying. Yeah, the, Claymore really likes to miss, or not the Claymore, the, Greatsword really likes to go off of its aim, even when locked on. That is frustrating. Alright. I have made my way back. Ready to give this one attempt. Possibly a single attempt, depending on how badly it goes, but, yeah. Can't end this episode without giving it at least one try. Here we go. All right. Oh boy. Wow, that's a... That is worrisome. Oh boy. Okay, whoa, yikes. Let's, hide in here. Okay. So, I'm guessing, given what other folks seemed to say, that I need to find- whoop! Take cover. Ow! That hurt a lot. Oh, it was the skeleton, I see. Okay. Ugh, please live. I'm guessing I need to find a switch of some sort in here. Get out of here. Alright, is there a switch? Is there a switch? It's around here somewhere, I bet. Yes! Oh, I might die. Oh, cool. So many skeletons, though. So many. Okay. Yikes, watch it. With the magic. Oh. Hey! Whoa! Didn't know that was gonna happen. Cool, though. Ah, there's horses. There is horses. Wow, that's, them is some mad horses. Yikes. Hello, horses. Whoa, that's a pit. That is all the way a pit. Okay. Leave me alone, horse. Yeesh. Okay. Ah. What a horrible time to miss. Oh, crap. Man. Ugh. I want to win that fight. I really want to win that fight. I wonder if I can... Or when I come back next time, the next thing I'm going to attempt is to, rather than slowly and carefully fighting my way back there, which is time-consuming and eats up healing items, I'm going to try charging. Which may not go well, but that's what I'm going to try next time. So, thank you all for watching. And I will see you next time for some possible foolhardy behavior.